I was probably 14. I went to my first concert, a Lone Star concert, at the Jefferson Theater in Charlottesville. I realized that I knew pretty much every song, so I was singing at the top of my lungs. I just couldn't help but think, why can't I do this one day? I actually joined choir in high school, and I loved that to death. The dream just seemed so doable. It was like, if I could play guitar, write good songs, and sing my ass off, we would be at the top one day. When I was 18, I bought my first guitar, the $100 guitar. I would go online and I learned to play. I said to myself, you know, if I'm gonna do this, what should I be focused on? It seems country is more fitting for who I am because I cut trees for a living and hunting all the time. Grew up in a log cabin, you know, I was like, well, this is what it is. I had been working on my album, just a preview, but I wasn't quite finished. So I took a song called She's the Party and singled it out and gave it away to about 1,000 people that night. Hopefully they put this into their car and they get hyped for the new album.
Sit right here on the edge of this pier. Watch the sunset disappear.
We just gotta be slow and in the field, all right?
Absolutely. Do the same, bro.
So I thought about it. What do I wanna be? A country music singer. Yeah, that sounds good to me.
You feel like Superman. But at the same time, you know as much as they know that you're just like them. You just have a guitar in your hand.
You just don't give up, man. Stay strong, it won't take long.
It just makes me super happy to see that people like what you're doing.
A little luck in a pickup truck. I'm all alone, I'm on the way. The bright lights are calling my name.
My first budget for the record ended up not being nearly enough. The guys who were working on it were great, but it wasn't exactly what I was looking for, so I had to search for the right guy to help me finish the product. And I found a young guy who I could afford.
Very crisp and very nice.
He has the capabilities, I thought, no doubt.
You hear that little thump that comes around the front there?
Yeah, that's annoying, isn't it?
Yeah, when it happens in the truck, it's very intense.
What if we took all the acoustic out right there?
When you're in the studio world that I don't know so well, it's like he speaks Chinese and I'm speaking Japanese.
Start that over and like maybe let the very intro of that catch up to the volume that it's at.
I have no idea what that means.
Like in other words, turn it a little bit louder so we can judge it better.
The best thing I can do is step out of the room and try to hear it like all the rest of the people.
She's tough enough to withstand this wide open. I just don't give a damn, man, I am. Those green eyes, they don't lie, they send me right into.
After about 100 truck tests per song, we've got something.
I dream about her every night when I go to sleep. Though every answer she knows is from a Cosmo. She's the sun when it sets what I want to see. Every man's got a girl.
I'd be proud to show that to anybody.
Woo-hoo! I moved out right after high school and money was tight. I said, well, hell, I guess all I really know is cutting trees. So I bought some spikes, a saddle, some chainsaws and ropes, and I started knocking on doors. The goal was you do not go home till you've got at least a couple hundred dollars minimum in your pocket. When you're feeling comfortable, you sometimes live a little fast. I bought a street bike, and me and some of my buddies, they had a bike too. We like to stunt and ride wheelies, and we see cops, you know, we run them. We'd ride on this mountain. One night we were racing over it, and a state trooper, he come around the bend and about head-on collision with me.
I swerved right up between the two cars, and it was all I could do to keep up. So I kicked off the guardrail. I was sitting right beside the car at that moment, and then I knew that cop would be coming on me.
And I knew that I could either pull over or I could run. And being as hard-headed as I was, I chose to run. I got away, I hid behind a house on a dead-end road. And I talked to that man. He let me chill with him for a minute. Cop come down right here. And then when he did, he walked right up through this yard right here like somebody done told him where I was. So right there on that ground right there, and they handcuffed me and threw me up in the car right here, son. The judge and the district attorney ended up giving me a decision of take a felony charge or take 6 months in jail. I didn't want a felony to ride with me for my whole life. Plus, I love hunting, so I didn't want them to take my rights. And the 6 months is what I did. And I was in this right window right here.
Gotta be strong, do the best you can. 6 months in the county jail, turn a boy into a man.
They take your freedom away from you, they take your money, they take your woman, you ain't got nothing. But the one thing they couldn't take was my music. I'd write lyrics while I was in there. I'd hum songs. I'd sit in the corner and I'd close my eyes. I almost thought for a little while, you know, I might be kind of crazy. It was just the fact that I need music in my life.
Ain't nothing gonna change this country, boy, don't give a damn.
When you're at the lowest point in your life, you ask yourself, what am I here to do? I need to make a difference to show them that dreams can come true. I'd tell them boys when I was in there, I'd say, man, I'm gonna be a country music singer. Y'all gonna see me on the big stage. And you know, they're joking, they're saying, ah, he ain't nothing.
First off, you're gonna wanna know a little more, and why do we talk different with southern boys and men?
You just got to your lowest point. Now you're out, you're making a name for yourself, and you're still only 21. Then you wonder at the same time, where is this gonna lead?
This ain't just another ordinary town, moonshine by the fire. I bet you won't ever want to leave.
We cut the record in a day, and then it took me a year and a half to get it sounding half right. It ended up costing me well over $50,000, which I funded independently.
Make you fall in love with what you see till you won't stay.
God, feels good today. Tree cutting's just in my blood. My uncles do it, my dad grew up doing it. He taught me how to climb trees and cut them down and try to be the best at what you do.
Down in my blood, know that I'm a tree cutting. that pain. For what it's worth, my back still hurts to this day. It may not suit you, I've done the best I can. Deep down in my blood, know that I'm a tree-cutting man.
Music is my true passion, but everything wouldn't be the same if it wasn't for tree cutting. So you gotta do what you gotta do to get where you wanna go.
It's really sweet.
You just saved the whole night.
And I work too much. I'm slowly digging up out of this rut with a Kubota I found on Craigslist. Had to drive to Minnesota to go get it, but I make more money every load. So that's the only thing that I know. We don't need no bank, won't take no loans. And everything we eat is homegrown. If I want it, I'ma get it with the wood grain in it. Any kind of way, I won't spend it. Big ass truck with the four wheel drive.
When you're making a record, there has to just come a point where you know that you spend enough time and enough money on it, you can hear it and say, this is good enough. I feel confident in the songs and confident in the sound to know that this is what I'll hear for the rest of my life.
You want to see the CD?
Yeah.
It's so many, right?
I mean, the honest truth of it is each song on the record is who I am and what I do.
Hard version. Got some thanks in there, you know, and mm-hmm. Then I put all the people's stuff right here. Damn. Mm-hmm. 2 years, man. Got it, son. Now I just gotta sell it. I love it. And I'm gonna go get the rest.
I said, well, shit, how am I gonna get my record out to people, so especially the ones who know me and grew up with me? So I set up a bonfire party. I believe we had about 700 people out there. It's probably the biggest throwdown I think most of us have ever seen. Had a lot of help from people who were just putting in their time.
We start the night young, she's getting dressed.
The records got out, people got tore up. That was one hell of a night.
Jacked up truck, cooler full to the top.
That's what it's all about, baby, right here, right now. That's how we do it in Nick Smith Country.
Better than that sexy country girl dancing on my tailgate once again. Whiskey is her best friend, breaking hearts when she drops it to the ground. Man, that girl can get down in this town. She's the one they've been talking about. There's a party coming out.
It's just really exciting for me to see that the music's selling, people are checking it out, talking about it. That's what it's all about right there. Yeah, I grew up around a lot of drinking. My mother, she had alcohol problems herself. She drank about 4 days. She'd be clear for 4 other days. Pick us up from school and take you practice, and we loved her for that so much, you know. It'd be on and off for a couple years, and when I was 16, she passed from drinking.
Tell me why a lesson in life can come so strong.
Being that I had never really experienced being drunk, it was pretty easy for me, starting so young, to be able to not drink and choose to not do drugs.
My mama tried to get me to understand. I thought it was a man, but the bottle was her best friend. Up until the day she passed away, I cried.
She may have saved my life, in a sense, is the way I like to think about it. You know, that's what a mother's supposed to do, is protect her children. In my sense, that's what she did.
Show him who I am, whoop his ass, cause he ain't my friend. That's the way I would handle it. Whiskey was my end.
I mean, half the reason I don't drink is I just want people to know me for me. With a clear head, exactly the way I am.
And if I could, I would change one thing.
I've been writing for my next album already.
The hard way.
I learned so much with just a preview album.
Sometimes you gotta slow down for the little things.
I'm gonna push harder. I'm gonna take the music farther. And I'd just like everybody to know who I am.
And don't ever walk away.
And I like that to show through my music.
You take the blame. And every lesson that
for those who know me, know that this is something that I enjoy and will do for the rest of my life. For those who don't know me, you can listen to this first record of mine and know that this is just a preview for what's to come. I'm definitely not even a percentage of the way of where I want to be. This isn't just about me. It's not just about the music. It's really just to represent the fact that if you want something bad enough, you can go out and achieve it. It may take a lifetime, but you can achieve it.